Now, if you're in the middle of first setting up your system, you want to build something into it that'll help you diagnose problems if you do have a problem with interfaces later on. And that's what you'll find under this Unient tab here in ICU. We have these health points, performance counters, and performance points. And I'm going to list them and talk about them like that in that order, because that's really about the order I would suggest setting these up in, going from the most recent, you know, best technology to some of the older things that we've done. So what a health point does is it monitors the, you know, the various things that monitor the health of your interface. So one of the things you'll find here is an IO rate tag. Now that's a tag that's just simply monitoring the number of events per second that we're getting from that interface. And obviously if that ever falls to zero, that's indicating there's some kind of a problem with that interface. So it's a good way to just kind of measure what's out there, what's going on your interfaces, and you can build notifications or, you know, other types of alarms onto that if you're interested, so that you can be informed if you've got an interface that's failing. Now, I suggest these health points first because they're our most recent technology. They do require a fairly recent version of the Unient that the interface is going to have to be based on. And if we take a look at the help file that comes with ICU on this topic, we describe the requirements right here. If we take a look at our health points, as you can see, it's only those interfaces that are built with Unient version 4.3 or later that are going to support these health points. And so it is the latest and kind of the best and easiest mechanism for monitoring what's going on in your tags. And there's a variety of things. We can monitor device status, we can create a heartbeat tag, and a variety of other things. For example, we can look at scan classes individually for IO rate. Now, but what that means is if I've got five different scan classes and I'm trying to balance out, say, 3,000 tags being scanned, I could do 1,500 on scan class 2 and 1,500 on scan class 3. And then this will measure for me what the IO is coming in from those individual scan classes. You can also measure the amount of time it takes to execute that scan class. So if you look down here, this is scan class 0. Let's go down to scan class 1 here. There's something called scan time. That's going to measure how long it takes to go through all the tags that are in that scan class. So if, for example, you're scanning it once every 2 seconds, and you find it takes 4 seconds to go through this scan class for all the tags that are being scanned, then you know you've got a problem. You'll probably see this scans skipped show some skipping's been occurring. So, you know, these are the types of nice informational things that you can use for keeping track of what's going on with the interfaces, and we strongly suggest you use this. Now, this one right here, this interfaces information, that's something that's actually created for a single Pi server, or you can only create one of these per Pi server. What this is doing is it on the home node, it will reflect just the activity and the amount of tags being scanned for all of your interfaces. So that's a real handy way of finding, you know, all the stuff that's out there. The scan classes that are defined for each of your interfaces, how many interfaces they are, what computers they're located on, how many tags we're finding for each interface. All that stuff is kind of put together in a big long string that you'll find in here. So we strongly recommend you use that. It's a good one to have. Now, in addition to these health points, we also support something that's a little older, and it's a little bit more difficult to implement because it requires a little bit more. These are performance counters, and I say it's more difficult because it's basically going to require that you have the licensed version of the performance monitor interface installed on the interface node in order for this to work. See, our performance monitor interface, and I'll switch over to it here. See, that's our performance monitor interface. It's the interface that will monitor certain Windows performance counters. So we publish certain metrics to the performance counters from the interfaces. And this is your way of grabbing that data from the performance counters and stuffing it into Pi. So if you have that fully licensed version of the PerfMon interface, you know, great, you can go ahead and implement this. Just go into performance counters, and you'll see the whole variety of performance counters you can do, almost all of which are duplicated in the health points. So again, this doesn't require anything extra to be licensed or configured, but this does require the performance monitor interface, the full version. And of course, since it's an interface running on a remote node, you're going to have to configure the interface, you're going to have to create a trust for it, etc. Now, an example of when you might want to use this interface instead of using the health points is if you do have an interface that is not, you know, up to speed with the more recent version of UniInt that will support health points. So that would be an example. And it's a little more inconvenient because you do have to have that performance monitor interface running. But if you don't have support for health points, this is a good option. Now finally, if you don't have the performance monitor interface and you would like to do some, you know, some kind of monitoring, you can always use these performance points if your interface supports it. Now this particular interface doesn't support it because it supports health points. We really don't need to support this older technology when we have health points. See, what a performance point is it's simply a way to measure how long it takes an interface to go through all the tags in its scan class or in a given scan class. So for example, if I go into the random interface here and I look at these performance points, these two points right here that I can just, you know, create if I choose to, these will measure how long it takes this random interface to scan all the tags that are scan class 1 and all the tags that are scan class 2. So what you would do is measure that, you know, check to see if it's scanning in a timely fashion. If your scan class is 2 seconds and it's taking 4 seconds, then obviously you're probably missing some scans. So look for that in performance points. But as I said, I would start with health points. If your interface supports that, then you've got the latest and the best way of creating this. Now, all of these things are created, or all these performance points are created in ICU by just right-clicking. So if I've got everything in place for health points, I would just right-click, go ahead and create that tag, and that would create the tags for me. Now, if you're going to be using performance counters, here's some of the things we suggest you take a look at. Here's the uptime in seconds. Here's the I/O rates overall for the interface. This is just the point count. And then down here, we're looking at the individual scan class. That's the scan class, the amount of time it takes to scan through all the tags in scan class 1. In this case, it's less than a second. Now, for configuring health points, there's three that we would generally recommend. First of all, the I/O rate, which is right here. Another tag we recommend is this heartbeat tag, but generally only when you're using one of our programs that requires a heartbeat tag. There's several programs that we have that will take a look at an interface and look at some tag that just arbitrarily generates a value at the minimum scan time. And then lastly, there's a real nice tag here called scans skipped. So yeah, when we're looking at the individual scan classes, as you can see, you can create a health tag that simply tells you, are we skipping any values? So that would be a good one to keep an eye on.